Environmental challenges are everywhere, from waste management to climate change. But as daunting as that may seem, we have the tools to meet them.
People are driving climate change. People are driving habitat destruction. People are driving a lot of our problems with conservation. And that's what we've finally come to realize, is that for people problems, we need people solutions.
The challenge we're facing with a lot of environmental work is that the approaches and methods that we're using now, many of them aren't working. They're not working at the scale or the timeline needed to really address these problems before they get worse.
In 2020, the Scientific and Technical Advisory Panel for the Global Environment Facility partnered with the Center for Behavior in the Environment to review the evidence for applying behavioral and social science to create environmental solutions.
The Scientific and Technical Advisory Panel of the Global Environment Facility, or the GEF, is a really significant partner on this work. In the last 30 years, the GEF has awarded more than $21 billion in grants to environmental projects on behalf of its member countries. And when they asked us to work on this with them, we were really excited because the GEF is then showing that they are really a partner on this work.
The BE Center within RARE right now stands as one of the world leaders when it comes to applying behavioral insights to conservation and environmental problems. What we didn't currently have was a kind of framework or a really comprehensive review that put all of these insights together in one place so that practitioners can use them.
We aim to fill that in two parts. First, we looked at the literature and found, well, what's already happening? And second, we translated the insights from that literature into practical guidance on how to develop better behaviorally informed programming, as well as better monitoring around behaviorally informed indicators.
So we wanted to provide both this what in terms of the science and as well as the how in terms of how people can actually take these tools and use them in their work.
So our partnership with the Global Environment Facility really allowed us to not just reach people that we wouldn't be able to before, but actually shape the field. This is really the first time that practitioners that are not behavioral scientists will be able to get easy access to the evidence that exists, but also be able to use our framework and the different criteria we've identified to systematically go through the evidence, understand their context, and fix their problem.
Our goal was to provide resources and insights and tools for anyone who's working on environmental challenges.
So please join us to inspire change through the science of human behavior so people and nature thrive.